Forest fires are natural, but the number and extent of fires witnessed today are not. Extreme heat is also becoming more frequent as a result of climate change. Droughts threaten our agriculture, and heat waves are becoming a danger, especially in cities. How can we protect ourselves and our planet become more resilient? And what role can technology play in this? We're in Munich, in the OroraTech laboratory. Founded in 2018, the startup sends small satellites with infrared cameras into space to monitor the effects of climate change.
We measure the Earth's temperature. We looked into different applications and we identified that measuring temperature is something that is not done very accurately. We decided to go for the space-based solution and developed our own optics, our own instruments to do it really on a true global scale from space. My name is Victor Gauck and I'm the CFO of OroraTech.
In 2020, an area equivalent to 650,000 football pitches was destroyed by forest fires in Europe. By 2050, they will increase by up to 33%. A global early warning system is urgently needed, but data provided by NASA or ESA is limited, as it's patchy and only available 2 times a day.
We focus on getting the highest possible time resolution, because when you're looking at wildfires or when you're looking at things like temperature, you want to detect a change over time.
OroraTech aims to provide data every 30 minutes. By 2026, 100 of their cameras should be in space. To achieve this goal, they have just completed another successful round of financing. Speed of data is one competitive advantage, and compactness of hardware another.
When we're speaking about sending something to space, it's really important to have the least volume and the least amount of weight possible. Our camera is about the size of a shoebox. It's really small. Normal thermal infrared cameras normally require a big cooling system around it, and we, through our technology and our development of the camera, have removed that cooling system.
The miniaturized high-tech in space is complemented by an analytics core on the ground.
We collect thermal infrared data from our own satellites and a lot of other data that is available. So that includes satellite data from other satellites, that includes weather data, and it includes customer data. We have a very strong analytics core with algorithms and AI that then analyzes that data and provide the information to customers throughout the world to warn them where a wildfire is happening in a timely manner.
With this information, wildfires can be fought before they become disasters. Current customers are commercial forestries in South America, national parks in Australia, and NGOs in Africa. Klabin from Brazil, one of the largest paper producers in the world, already use the data to better coordinate their firefighters on the ground. But wildfire detection and suppression is one of many potential applications. The analytics core can update on all thermal contexts.
Beyond wildfire, we see opportunities in the urban heat sector to make the cities more climate resilient, as well as agricultural applications and sea surface temperature measurements.
In the near future, data from space will be standard. The new space sector is quickly evolving. Annual investment in space startups grew from $300 million to $10 billion. There are currently 8,000 satellites in space. About 170 are added every month, with the trend increasing.
I believe that in future, every company will rely on space-based services without knowing it. And therefore, the ecosystem will evolve, it will speed up, space services will be a commodity. The data helps us to understand the natural phenomena better and therefore make our planet more resilient towards natural disasters in future.